हेलो एवरीवन, देयर वाज अ रिसेंट डाउट व्हिच वाज आस्क्ड। द क्वेश्चन इज द मैक्सिमम रिडक्शन इन क्रॉस सेक्शनल एरिया पर पास दैट इज आर ऑफ अ कोल्ड वायर ड्राइंग प्रोसेस इज आर इज इक्वल टू 1 माइनस ई टू द पावर माइनस एन प्लस 1, वेयर एन रिप्रेजेंट्स द स्ट्रेन हार्डनिंग कोफिशिएंट फॉर द केस ऑफ परफेक्टली प्लास्टिक मटेरियल आर इज। ओके सो गाइस, दिस इज द केस ऑफ कोल्ड वायर ड्राइंग प्रोसेस। So in the drawing process, the formula is R is equal to 1 minus e to the power minus n plus 1, which is given over here. But if you see the actual formula is R is equal to 1 minus e to the power minus efficiency, eta term is there, then n plus 1. What is the efficiency of drawing? Okay, and this value tells you the maximum strain while drawing. Okay, so one numerical was also asked in gate regarding to just this formula. So right now just focus over here that we have this formula that tells you about the reduction per pass. Okay, now so what is the value of reduction for this for the case of perfectly plastic material? So perfectly plastic material, right? Now if you see the stress strain diagram of normal material, then it goes something like this. Okay, it goes something like this. This is your engineering stress and strain diagram. Okay, now someone tells you like it is a perfectly plastic material or perfectly elastic material, then how the stress strain diagram changes? So it changes like, see, till here it will be somewhat like this. Then if it is a straight line, a horizontal straight line, then this is a case of perfectly plastic material. Okay, so why it is a perfectly plastic material is that, now see, after just crossing the elastic region, you can see there is a permanent deformation which is happening over here without any increase of this strain, without any increase of the stress value. That means there is no any strain hardening which is taking place. So a material without any strain hardening will be called as a perfectly plastic material if deformation is going through and the final length it will change. But the only thing is that the increase of stress will not be there. Now suppose if there is someone tells you about this perfectly elastic material, perfectly elastic material, that means it goes beyond and beyond and beyond. Okay, it goes beyond and beyond and there is no any plastic deformation. Okay, this is just the elastic region which is over here, right? So guys, now for this case we know this n value that corresponds to this strain hardening coefficient. We know sigma is equal to k epsilon to the power n, right? Now if you put n is equal to 0, then this sigma becomes equal to some constant k, right? Some constant value of k, right? So see here, so here this equation is valid in the plastic region, so right? So now you see here in the plastic case, this sigma is equal to k, that means it has got some value. So, and this is a fixed value. So you can see here, this is just the fixed value which is given over here. So that's why for a perfectly plastic material, n value will be 0, right? And for a perfectly elastic material, this n value will be equal to 1. How? Now see, if I put 1 over here, so sigma is equal to k epsilon. Now if you keep on increasing this epsilon, that is a strain, this sigma value will keep on increasing, right? So this will tell you that up to infinite strain, the stress value is directly proportional. So there is no any plastic deformation which is happening over here. right? So that's why it is called as a perfectly elastic material. So for a perfectly elastic material, the n value is equal to 1, and for a perfectly plastic material, this n value is 0. Okay, and for the real material which we daily encounter, like steel, aluminium, everything, so this n value ranges from like 0.1, 0.5. okay, so it ranges between this. Okay, now so let us come to the question. We know this R is equal to 1 minus e to the power minus n plus 1, right? So for a perfectly plastic material, this n value should be 0. So R will be equal to 1 minus e to the power minus 0 plus 1. So it will be 1 minus 1 by e. So it will be e minus 1 by e. Okay. So you calculate the value of this and you'll get this value, right? Okay. Hope this will help you. Okay. Thank you, guys.